21st of April, 4 in the morning. Just came back from California. I respected the lockdown rules and stayed at home. Living like a monk. Resting, reading, napping or meditating in my bedroom. There's nothing interesting to tell about that. Anyway, this time we're going to the United Kingdom. I think I never told you that Romainly Movie Geek is very Anglophile. London is one of his favorite place in the world, even under the rain. See how happy he looks. Maybe because he grown up in the north of France.
Quoi? Coucou de boeuf?
Close to his English neighbors. Or more probably, because he watched a lot of British TV shows during his youth.
This is Simon Templar.
The Saint. The Avengers. Especially the Emmett Peel era.
Aren't you ready yet, Steed?
Just coming, Mrs. Peel.
It's the first time I've had to wait for a man to get ready.
Ah, you're judging man by 20th century standards.
The Monty Python.
Attack me!
Or the Persuaders, with the unforgettable synthesizer theme tune by John Barry. It's impossible not to mention the James Bond films.
My name is...
James is for tombstones, baby.
Some of his favorite filmmakers are British, like Carol Reed, David Lean, Ken Russell, Ridley Scott, John Boorman, Alan Parker, Alfred Hitchcock, or Ingmar Pressburger and Michael Powell. He also has a deep admiration for one of the most precious gifts that the Brits gave to the world of the 20th century. Music. Pink Floyd, Led Zeppelin, The Rolling Stones, The Beatles, The Who, Iron Maiden, Black Sabbath, Genesis, The Cure, Roxy Music, Cocteau Twins, The Police, Queen, The Smiths, The Kinks. And many, many others. But let us not forget, God. If I could choose to live as an adult in a different time period, it would definitely be from the mid-60s to the late 70s. Being at the premiere of the biggest movies, or in the crowd of the greatest concerts of all time, no face mask or physical distancing, there are so many historical events that I would want to witness. Probably be dead before the 80s from an OD, or all bunch of sexually transmitted diseases, but at least, I would have had fun. Ah! Life is a bitch and here we are, stuck in 2021. A Frenchman who loves United Kingdom, I guess it must be surprising from an outsider's point of view, considering the complex historical ties between the French and the British. But it is comforting to see that France and the UK are the best friends in the world now. They both can count on each other for help and for support during troubled as well as happy times. They are allies, neighbors, friends, and also genetically cousins. I've digressed a lot, now it's time to talk about British cinema after this very cliche presentation.
Who are you?
The 20th century.
My name is Bond.
James Bond.
Something wrong?
The Queen of Sin.
Mrs. Peel!
I was cured, all right.
As you understood, he mostly saw British movies in March, and his top 5 includes only British films. I have the list. It reads, Hi Dale. Before starting, here are a few honorable mentions. I finally saw the Palme d'Or winner of 2006, The Wind That Shakes the Barley, by Ken Loach, a war drama film about two brothers fighting together during the Irish War of Independence, but find themselves on opposite sides during the ensuing Irish Civil War.
Just brother to brother.
What do you want, Teddy?
Tell us where the arms are, Damien. Take amnesty. Go home and live the life you should be living.
Also at the gates of the top 5, Murder by Decree.
I have been witness to much strange events.
Sherlock Holmes vs. Jack the Ripper, an adventure not based on a Conan Doyle story. Christopher Plummer did a terrific job as the famous detective, and the rest of the cast is incredible as well. Genevieve Bujo, David Hemmings, Donald Sutherland, and James Mason is Dr. John Watson. Now it's time to begin the top 5 list.
And now for something completely different.
We start with a beautiful love story. The movie that brought Audrey Hepburn back to the screen after an 8-year absence. Robin and Marian, directed by Richard Lester. Robin Hood was a hero of my childhood, and I still remember Disney's 1973 animated version with animal characters. The cast is extraordinary. Sean Connery plays an aging Robin Hood, Hepburn is Lady Marian, Robert Shaw is the Sheriff of Nottingham, Richard Harris is Richard the Lionheart, Ian Holm is King John, and also a very young Victoria Abril as Queen Isabella. It's a very touching movie, with a heartbreaking ending and a beautiful score by John Barry. It's definitely better than the Ridley Scott's Robin Hood from 2010.
Let us put these friends to bed!
I love Ridley Scott, and I know that Robin Hood is simple entertainment, but sometimes...
That's a lot of French.
He goes a little bit too far with historical inaccuracies.
It's a history lesson come to life.
No, it isn't. It's totally inaccurate.
Wait, here come the ninjas.
And now for something completely different.
This year, next year, sometime never.
I Start Counting, starring a very young Jenny Agutter.
I start counting.
In this 1969 coming-of-age thriller by director David Green, she plays Winkinch, a Catholic teenager living with her adoptive family in an English working-class town. She is madly in love with her stepbrother George, but she starts to think he could be involved in a series of rapes and murders of young women in the locality. The film was released just before a decade of violent rural crime stories in the British cinema. Villain, in 1971, starring Richard Burton.
Hello, Benny.
Get Carter, the same year. This is a film with a message. And the message is, don't fuck with Michael Caine.
Hey, did you see that?
Or The Offense by American director Sidney Lumet, starring Sean Connery in one of his best performances.
His white shirt had splintered bones. Filthy, swarming, slimy maggots in my mind. Eating.
I Start Counting and The Offense were both shot in Bracknell, in the Berkshire region. Even though she was young, Agutter was already brilliant. I Start Counting has very atmospheric, creepy scenes, although sometimes it has some parts of comedy and some light moments. And there is an 18-year-old Phil Collins as an ice cream vendor.
Vanilla, please. Have you got a Napolitano Tutti Frutti?
Aye.
I Start Counting.
Something completely different.
Time Lost and Time Remembered, also known as I Was Happy Here.
I was happy here.
You probably remember Sarah Miles from Ryan's Daughter, where she plays, well, Ryan's daughter. If you don't, then go see it. It's a wonderful classic. Miles plays Cass, a lonely and unhappy young wife who returns to her old Irish seacoast town after a fight with her conservative husband. Told mostly in flashbacks, this is a beautiful melancholic movie of the 60s, with a beautiful black and white cinematography and a great editing.
Come.
And now?
Do you remember last year, my favorite movie of 2020? Threads by Mick Jackson. Well, here's another delightful TV movie with the same nightmarish situations. The War Game.
This family couldn't afford to build themselves a refuge. This could be the way the last 2 minutes of peace in Britain would look.
Made in the 60s by Peter Watkins, The War Game is a fascinating, terrifying, and disturbing TV docudrama about nuclear devastation and the collapse of the working society.
Now, director, on the command, cut to the next scene. Director!
And now my favorite movie of the month.
Wait for it! Director! Cut!
And now my favorite movie of the month. The Servant, by American director Joseph Losey. This dark allegorical tale is a brilliant dissection of the struggle between two men for power. It's the first script for the cinema by British writer Harold Pinter, based on a novel by Robin Maugham. The entire cast is remarkable. Dirk Bogarde, James Fox, Wendy Craig, and Sarah Miles again.
Oh, I'm glad I'm not alone. Well, I didn't fancy being alone by myself in this house.
There's also a magnificent camera work and a beautiful cinematography by Douglas Slocum.
I want an explanation. Might I speak to you alone, please, sir? You realize you've committed a criminal offense? Criminal, sir.
And now for something completely different.
Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel.